I request Honorable the President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, to inaugurate this conference by lighting the ceremonial lamp. I request the dignitaries on the dais to accompany him. Thank you, sirs. With the lighting of the ceremonial lamp, I request Honorable Mr. Justice Manmohan Sarin to present a memento to Honorable the President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, to welcome him on this occasion. I request Shri Swatantra Singh, Up Lokayukta Uttar Pradesh, to present a memento to Shri Ashwini Kumar, Union Minister for Law and Justice. I request Honorable Mr. Justice K.K. Dineshan, Lokayukta Kerala, to present a memento to the Lieutenant Governor NCT of Delhi, Shri Tejinder Khanna. I request Shri Chandresh Bhushan, Up Lokayukta Madhya Pradesh, to present a memento to Shri V. Narayana Sami, Minister of State for Personnel, Public Grievances, Pensions and PMO. I request Shri Krishna G. Rao, Up Lokayukta Andhra Pradesh, to present a memento to Honorable Mr. Justice R. M. Lodha, Judge Supreme Court of India. I request Mr. Rakesh Sayal, Special Judge CBI Delhi, to present a memento to Honorable Mr. Justice P. P. Navlekar, former Judge Supreme Court of India, Lokayukta Madhya Pradesh. I request Mr. A.K. Kuhar, officer on special duty in the office of the Lokayukta Delhi, to present a memento to Honorable Mr. Justice Sanjay Kishan Kaul, Judge High Court of Delhi.
Good afternoon to all of you. Shri Ashwini Kumar, Minister of Law and Justice, Shri Tejinder Khanna, Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, Justice Rajendra Mohan Lodha, Judge Supreme Court of India, V. Narayan Swami, Minister, Personnel, Public Grievance, Pensions, and in the Prime Minister's Office, Justice Manmohan Sarin, Lokayukta Delhi, Justice Sanjay Krishan Kaul, Judge High Court of Delhi, Justice Bipul Navlekar, former Judge, Supreme Court of India and Lokayukta of Madhya Pradesh, Honorable Judges of the Supreme Court, Judges of the High Court, former Judges, Senior Officers, Distinguished Persons in the Legal Professions, Guests, Beloved Students, Ladies and Gentlemen. Indeed, I am happy to participate in the inaugural ceremony of the 11th All India Lokayuks Conference, which brings together Lokayuks of different states to discuss ways and means of enhancing effectiveness of this institution. This All India Lokayuks Conference bring different stakeholders together so that views can be shared on the challenges and best practices. With such a wide range of experienced participants, I am quite confident discussions will bring forth concrete suggestions and initiatives for strengthening Lokayuks and making them more purposeful. In recent times, there has been concern over the need to ensure that corridors of power remain untainted by corruption or nepotism, and there is optimum utilization of resources and funds for their intended purposes. This national conference is therefore timely and appropriate. For the successful working of democracy, people should be confident that the government policies are formulated and implemented with honesty, transparency, and fairness. As all of you are aware, Lokayuk, or the Ombudsman, was originally conceived in Scandinavian countries as a watchdog of the administration as well as protector of the common man. Despite having minimal power to implement decisions, the Ombudsman played a very useful role in those countries by bringing humanism in governance. In India, M.C. Sitalbhat, an eminent jurist, in his speech at the All India Lawyers Conference held in 1962, suggested the idea of establishing an institution similar to that of an ombudsman. This idea was extensively investigated by the first Administrative Reforms Commission in 1966, and while recommending setting up of Lokpal at the center and Lokayuks in the states, this commission advocated ombudsmanic institutions as a means for redressal of citizens' grievances containing corruption and removing discontent among citizens. Over the years, India witnessed rapid growth. The extent of public spending has steadily strengthened. For one example, the first revenue budget of independent India, presented by the then Finance Minister Sri Shanmugam Chetty, was just a meager figure of 197 crore 15 lakhs, and revenue expenditure was ₹197.39 crores, and leaving a budget deficit of just ₹26 crore 25 lakhs. Whereas the last budget, which I presented in my capacity as finance minister, was of the order of 12 lakh crores of rupees. The first five-year plan had the total outlay of just 2,000 crores of rupees, and the 11th five-year plan, which have just been completed, had an outlay of more than 11 lakh crores of rupees.